You already sold the land to the Zionists. Get it back from them. Though some other people say, I still have the key. I keep it. I know where my house is. Sooner or later, either me, my generation, or second generation, or third or fourth, they will inherit that key and go back to their houses there. Do you have a key for Palestine in your pocket? Or no, because I'm not a Palestinian. You have to understand. So that's why when we celebrate this, Sha'ban, the changing of the Qibla, we should know the essence behind it, the significance behind it, the wisdom behind it. لازلنا في رحاب المصطفى البر لا يبلى والذنب لا ينسى والديان لا يموت كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون والتائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأصلي وأسلم على رسول الله صلاة وتسليما يليقان بالحبيب المصطفى النبي المجتبى صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وتابعيه وتابعي تابعيه إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our children, boys and girls, sons and daughters, the future of Islam, insha'Allah, Rabbil Alameen. Yeah, for a while, yani, some people, very beloved ones to me, wallahi, brothers and sisters, once in a while they come to me and say that, oh, you're more of a politician now. You speak a lot of politics. I say, subhanAllah, Rabbil Alameen, tab, why not? Yani, politics is not part of our life, yani. Or we're here in this masjid, once I occupy this podium and pray and you pray behind me, it's only yani salah, zakah, sawm, tahara, wudu, and we're done. Salaamu alaikum, we'll see you next week. This is our daily affairs. This is our life. This is our life. Believe it or not, wallahi, if we sacrifice our life this way, especially when it comes to Palestinian issue, wallahi, we're done. We're done. Khalas. Yani, let's say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Yani, khalas. We belong to Allah and to Him we'll go back. Yani, the issue is over. Yani, let the UN or SN or any in or any whatever take care of it. We're done. Wash our hands out of it. Ya Allah. No. هذه شؤون حياتنا. Like it or not, we'll talk about it. We'll discuss it. We'll learn from it. Subhanallah. You know why? Because at that time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a group of people, at that time, the Jewish people, okay? What did they say? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealing to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, here is what they said, here is what they will be saying in the Quran, in Al-Baqarah 2142. سيقول السفهاء من الناس ما ولاهم عن قبلتهم التي كانوا عليها. سيقول السفهاء من الناس ما ولاهم عن قبلتهم التي كانوا عليها. السفيه وجمع السفيه سفهاء. وقرآن is revealing to those سفهاء, the fool people. At that time there were the Jews people there. Why you change your qibla? Why are you playing this game? Yani sometimes Al-Quds, and now forget about Al-Quds, now Al-Kaaba, and we never know what's next, maybe Al-Madina, or maybe somewhere else, maybe Nigeria, or Ghana, or Uganda, or Egypt. What is going on? That's why the Quran yani is describing them as fool. They don't understand the wisdom, the significance, the essence behind this. In order for them to believe and say, yes, you Allah, you're taking the right decision in here. Muhammad, you tell them the following. Here is the answer. We're not telling you they are saying such and such or doing such and such and leave them alone. No, here is the answer. Tell them this and tell them today. Because in many occasions of inner faith and multi-faith dialogue, I have been, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, involved in, that question would come up. I say, why all of those changing and direction and so on and so forth. I say, as Allah says, you Muhammad say, قُلْ لِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبِ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صُرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. If you're talking about east or west, all of them belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can direct, he can say whatever he say. He can tell us what to do. It does not belong to me. It does belong to him. He knows the best. Absolutely no doubt about it. He knows what would be the best for us to do in that direction. For how many months or how many years and toward what and so on and so forth. قُلْ لِلَّهِ الْمَشْرِقُ وَالْمَغْرِبِ Muhammad, tell them definitely, certainly, without any doubt, east and west belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have no business in Allah's affairs. That's it. That's it. يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صُرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ He will guide whom he will to the straight way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you're among those one to be guided, alhamdulillah. If you're not among those one who are guided, you brought it to yourself. Because you do not believe, you disbelieve in Allah's decision when it comes to those changing. Alright? We know the essence, we know the wisdom, we know the reason behind it. For us today, do we believe it? Do we capitalize on it? Did we really truly follow it? When we have that direction, or in our prayer, whether here or anywhere, I have that vision blocked at that distance. My vision, my heart, my soul, my mind never go beyond that geographical location. It does not go to Mecca. It does not connect really well with Mecca. It is not related to the sacred house where the birth of Islam was. Where I have to be connected there, no matter what is going on today. No matter who's taking care of it. No matter who's behind what is going on there. But it is me as a Muslim, follow that direction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Capitalize on it. While you're having your vision, go all the way to Mecca there. In the meantime, keep in mind, deeply in your heart, in your soul as well. As-salatu mi'rajul mu'min. Celebrating the mi'raj of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the heaven, you are in your salah. Physically, your body, you're here. But your soul and your heart up there with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in mi'raj there. If you take it this way, believe me, as Allah has instructed him, whatever you ask him for, he will answer you. Try and you'll find out. This is the beauty of Islam, the beauty of the salah. The beauty of the connectedness of our hearts and our souls and our mind with Allah, with our beloved Qibla, and with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, with Al Medina, with Mecca, and with Palestine, with Al Quds. That's why if we do this, we'll be victorious, we'll be superseding the whole world, we'll be leading the whole world. No one would be able to compete with us. Insha'Allah Rabbil Alameen. Insha'Allah Rabbil Alameen. Insha'Allah Rabbil Alameen. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعلي بفضلك راية الحق والدين وانصرنا على عدوك وعدونا يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر من نصر أمة محمد واجعلنا منهم واخذل من خذل أمة محمد ولا تجعلنا منهم اللهم ول أمورنا خيارنا ولا تول أمورنا شرارنا اللهم ول أمورنا خيارنا ولا تول أمورنا شرارنا اللهم حرر القدس السليبة اللهم حرر القدس السليبة اللهم حرر القدس السليبة اللهم حرر كل بقاع الإسلام يا رب العالمين من الأوغاد والأشرار اللهم أمين اللهم أمين اللهم اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا وفك أسرانا وفك أسرانا وكن لنا ولا تكن علينا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا اللهم برحمتك عمنا واكفنا شر ما أهمنا وعلى الإيمان الكامل والكتاب والسنة توفنا وأنت راض عنا اغفر اللهم لنا ولإخواننا في الله تعالى أحياء وأمواتا ولكل المسلمين أجمعين إليه هذا حلنا لا يخفى عليك وهذا ضعفنا ظاهر بين يديك فعاملنا بالإحسان إذ الفضل منك وإليك واختم لنا بخاتمة السعادة أجمعين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمركم بثلاث وأنهاكم عن ثلاث، إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه يزيدكم. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمني ويرحمكم الله، وأستودعكم الله.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد